Good afternoon, my dear students. I'm your Dr. Ananilakshmi Sandeep with new topic for the day from community medicine, that is screening and the differences between screening and diagnostic test. So how will I proceed with this topic? So I'm going to discuss this under following headings. First part would be introduction, which includes what is screening. Then what are the actual differences between screening and diagnostic test and small summary of it. So first let's begin with introduction for screening. So what is the biggest challenge in the world to us when we consider preventive medicine? The biggest challenge in preventive medicine is to distinguish between people who have the disease and those who do not have got the disease. Yes, actually this is the biggest challenge what we face in this modern world, to identify who are really diseased and who are healthy. So for this purpose, we need something called screening or screening test. So what do you mean by this screening? So here there is a definition which tells you what is screening. Screening is the search for unrecognized disease or defect by means of rapidly applied tests, examinations or other procedures in apparently healthy individuals. So I hope you are noting few points over here. See, it is a search for what? For unrecognized disease or defect. But how? By means of rapidly applied tests, examination or other procedures. But in whom are you going to do this? You are going to do this in not diseased individuals. Instead, it's in apparently healthy individuals. So, three or four words which you have to remember to describe screening are apparently healthy individuals, rapidly applied tests, examination or procedures, and search of unrecognized disease. So if you remember these three words, you can define screening. So I would repeat it once again. Screening is the search for unrecognized disease or defects by means of rapidly applied tests, procedures or examination in whom? In apparently healthy individuals. So with this background, let me tell you what are the differences between screening test and diagnostic test. See, before I would proceed with the differences, I would give you an example for screening test considering diabetes and diagnostic test considering diabetes. So if you take diabetes mellitus into consideration, if you are doing screening test for apparently healthy individuals, you may do random blood sugar or urine sugar. But if you want to really diagnose the disease in already people who are having symptoms, then probably you may have to do also fasting blood sugar levels, postprandial blood sugar levels, or even glycosylated hemoglobin levels. So let me tell you the basic differences between the screening test and diagnostic test. I hope all of you can follow this, what is projected over here. So first let me tell you the features, salient features of screening test, then let me compare it with the diagnostic test. So the first important point to be remembered with the screening test is it is done on apparently healthy individuals, as the definition goes. The second thing is it is applied to groups, not for a single person. So even if you're doing the screening test, it is done in groups. Okay. Third thing, results are arbitrary and final. See, this is what is dangerous. Think that the patient has taken lot, say some 8 or 10 gulab jamuns and has come for your screening test for sugar levels in his body. Automatically his blood sugar may be around 350 to 400. Now would you declare him as diabetic? Is that possible? No. This is what the drawback of screening test is, because the test is arbitrary and it is final. You cannot do fasting blood sugar levels for all, because nobody can stay for 8 hours of fasting for a long period of time when you consider it as a group. So results are arbitrary and they are final. Then it is based on one criteria and cutoff. There will be a standard method. It will have some criteria and a cutoff value. And depending on that, you will decide whether the person has got that disease or not. Now, let's compare these points with respect to diagnostic test. Screening test is done on whom? apparently healthy individuals, whereas diagnostic tests are done on whom? Sick or ill individuals. As I told you, screening test is applied for groups, but diagnostic test is applied on single patient. Results are arbitrary and final in case of screening test, but diagnosis is not final in case of diagnostic tests. Based on one criteria and cutoff, you do screening test. But here, in diagnostic test, based on evaluation of number of signs and symptoms and lab findings, you are going to diagnose. See, as I have given you example of diabetes in a patient, in a person who has taken around 8 to 10 gulab jamun at once and has come and the sugar level has shooted up to 350. With respect to screening test, you may call him as diabetic, which might not be true. But when it is diagnostic test, you will not just consider the spot sugar levels. Instead, also you will consider his signs, and also you will consider his symptoms, and also you will elicit few signs to call him diabetic or not. So these are few differences between screening test and diagnostic test. There are some more. Come, let's see it. So now let me tell you screening test other differences first. Screening test, as you all know, is less accurate and it is less expensive. How long will it take for us to do this test? Okay, and how costlier it would be to conduct this test? For example, if you consider diabetes itself again, RPS. Doing RPS might be cheaper, even sugar will be still more cheaper. But if you are planning to do glycosylated hemoglobin levels, FBS, PPBS levels, and all, it will be more costly. So it is actually less expensive. But quantity and quality, both are important. Quality, in terms of quality, you should always keep in mind that screening test is less accurate. So it means that if somebody has got HIV positive, it might be negative as well, and if it is negative, it doesn't rule out the disease. So it depends on which test we have used to screen a particular person. It is not a basis for treatment. It will just help you or guide you to decide whether the patient might have got disease or not, but it is not actually the basis of treatment. Then initiative comes from the investigator in case of screening disease, not from the patient. Let's compare it with the diagnostic test now. It is more accurate, it is more expensive, it can be used as the basis for treatment, and the initiative comes from the patient. So these are the basic differences between screening test and diagnostic test. Now a small summary of what we have studied in today's class. So we know that the biggest challenge in the world today is what? To distinguish between normal healthy people and diseased one. The screening test is the one which is nothing but the search of unrecognized disease or defect with making use of rapidly available tests, examination or other procedures which are applied to apparently healthy individuals. The differences, which mainly include: screening test is done on apparently healthy individuals, but diagnostic test on sick or ill individuals. Screening applied to groups, but this in single patient. Results are arbitrary and final, and it is based on one criteria and cutoff in screening test, whereas diagnosis is not final, and it is also based on signs, symptoms, and also lab findings in diagnostic test. Screening test is less accurate, less expensive, and not a basis of treatment when you compare it with the diagnostic test. The last difference is the initiative for the test is from investigator in case of screening test, whereas it is from the patient in case of diagnostic test. So this can be a 5-mark question in the exam. Thanks a lot.